I've talked a lot about utilizing a secondary hard drive for recording videos on my channel, be it with XSplit, OBS Studio, Elgato Game Capture HD, or anything else. A secondary hard drive, or solid state drive, physically different from your main OS C drive, is almost a requirement in my book for recording videos to your computer. But I've never really gone into detail in video form as to why you should record to a secondary drive. Let's talk about that. I'm EposVox, here to make tech easier to understand and more fun via free educational videos. There are two main reasons you'd want to use a secondary disk drive to record to: bottlenecking issues affecting the performance and quality of your recording, and the durability of your system on the whole. The biggest issue that you're going to care about, at least immediately, is your system bottlenecking. This means that something in your computer is restricting performance for everything else. In this case, your hard drive is the bottleneck. Your primary hard drive, the C drive in Windows, is already being constantly used and accessed to run your operating system, various programs, and probably even your game, if you're gaming on PC. This means a lot of data is being sent back and forth, and if you're on a standard mechanical hard drive, then the platters are already doing a lot of spinning and reading. They can only go so fast. If you're on a laptop, it's even slower. If you try to record an intensive process involving a ton of data being transferred to this drive, you can easily run into performance issues. Your whole system could slow down or lock up, or your recording can get messed up. There can be visual artifacts in the footage, such as pixelization or random glitching, or you just might not be able to keep up with the frame rate and just have super jittery, stuttery video. You don't want that. You just don't. Recording to a secondary drive that is only being accessed for the purpose of recording means a free flow of information with minimal performance issues or impact. Secondly, constantly recording to your OS hard drive can actually decrease the durability of your computer, especially if you're on a laptop. Laptop hard drives or other weaker hard drives only operate at 5400 RPM versus the 7200 RPM of bigger desktop hard drives, and they aren't made for the constant writing like that. Abusing the hard drive means you could wake up one day after rendering a video overnight only to find that your PC will only give you a sad blue screen. I've seen it plenty of times. So what can you do to prevent any of this from happening? Use a secondary disk drive. How you go about this exactly depends on your setup. A standard desktop is super easy to add a new hard drive to. I'm working on getting my own video online on how to do this, but in the meantime, there are thousands upon thousands of other guides online on how to do this. A little Google can go a long way. Many laptops, especially ones under $500, don't have the option for a secondary hard drive slot. If yours does, go ahead and add it in. The screws are usually fairly well labeled. If not, then you'll need to look into other options. On a desktop or laptop, if you have a USB 3.0 port on your computer, you can use a USB 3.0 external hard drive for recording. I, personally, shy away from this recommendation because external hard drives used to be made pretty cheaply and would burn out quicker than a laptop hard drive for recording. Nowadays, they're pretty good. You want to use a USB 3.0 hard drive, however, as a USB 2.0 drive often can't sustain the required data transfer rates for doing any real, like, quality recording. If you want to record like 240p, go right ahead. USB 2.0 drive will help, will do fine. But to do like 1080p, 1080p 60, 720p, you need a beefy connection, and USB 3.0 is that connection. And before you ask, no, don't record to a flash drive or an SD card. A fast enough SDXC UHS card might work with a USB 3.0 card reader, but overall it won't be a pleasant experience. Card readers are made for fast read speeds, not write speeds. And the flash chips on a flash drive will definitely die on you after recording for so long.
This video is brought to you by TubeBuddy, the best tool you can get to manage your YouTube channel, update videos in bulk, syndicate to social media, and back up your metadata and more, all with this simple browser extension. Head on over to eposvox.com/TubeBuddy to download it for free and learn more. TubeBuddy! Download for free! Learn more! I love it.
I hope this video has been helpful to you and finally answers some questions I've received for a long time. If you enjoyed it, smash the like button, get subscribed for more awesome tech videos. My name's EposVox, and I will see you next time.